My 2019 trip to Japan started with a short flight to Copenhagen, followed by a very long flight to Tokyo. I arrived and met up with my friend Serena, and after a short stop off at a Shiba Inu dog cafe, which was amazing by the way, we headed to our first park, Tokyo Dome City. The main attraction is Thunder Dolphin, a 262-foot tall Intamin hypercoaster. The ride completely dominates the park, and the way it weaves around the La Croix shopping mall makes for a really interesting layout. The ride reaches speeds of over 80 miles an hour, and its height makes it the second tallest coaster in Japan. By day, the roller coaster looks impressive, but by night, when lit up by floodlights, it truly is a sight to behold. So I'm here this evening at Tokyo Dome City with the awesome coaster Thunder Dolphin behind me, which you may be able to see if I look down like this. It's also quite unique in that there's a giant Ferris wheel here, which doesn't have anything in the middle, apart from the roller coaster. The ride itself is actually quite good fun as well. It's fairly neat because it's built around this sort of shopping mall. It's got a few really nice sort of dives down. There's a bit where it dives through a hole, which is fun. And it's quite steep in bits as well, and has a really good high-speed airtime hill. The drop as well is pretty amazing. It's like, I think it's like 260 feet, something like that. It's pretty big. And there's one weird thing about it. It's got the weird bit which goes along the top of the roof, which just is a silent, weird, wiggly bit. Doesn't really make any sense. It just feels a bit odd. And somehow there's like a bit of a strange smell up there as well. I think it's from the air conditioning. Anyway, this is Tokyo Dome. It's very easy to get to if you're in Tokyo, so well worth going to. Ride Thunder Dolphin. Stupid name, good coaster.
Thunder Dolphin isn't the only attraction worth doing at the park. The giant Ferris wheel gives some absolutely stunning views over Tokyo, particularly around about sunset. You can even choose what music you listen to as you go around, including classics such as Notifications and Bump of Chicken.
I'd be silly not to mention the horror attraction they've got here as well. It's really well thought out and quite scary in bits as well. My friend Serena spent the whole time with her eyes closed. She did it once before and it's been rethemed. The theme's a bit unusual as it's themed around moths for some reason, but it works out as a really fun haunt. It's mostly sort of mannequins and sort of well sort of put together scenes rather than sort of people jumping out going, ah. But it's really well done, and if you do come here, then don't miss it. It's well worth doing.
There's also a log flume at the park, which me and Serena both got completely soaked on. We had to sit at the front of the boat, which left it pretty nose heavy and left us pretty drenched when it hit the splashdown. We also rode the park's newest coaster, Panic Coaster Back Down. It's really quite a strange coaster. It starts with a launch into a dark room, and then when the car returns to the station, it has a backwards launch into the same room, except everything's lit up in these crazy lights. The park also has a few interesting places to eat, including this place, where you place an order for sushi on an iPad, and it arrives via a tiny toy train. It was pretty tasty too. Overall, Tokyo Dome was a great place to start our trip to Japan, and Thunder Dolphin was a fantastic introduction to Japanese coasters. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you again in another one very soon.